When the night has come, and when your feet are in the stocks, and when it appears everything has turned over against you, that is the time to pray and to sing. And then it says, I'm going to read that verse 25 again. And at midnight, Paul and Silas, no, they didn't murmur. Paul and Silas, no, they didn't complain. Paul and Silas, no, they didn't cry. Paul and Silas, they were not afraid of their enemies, of their persecutors. They prayed and they sang praises unto God. And the prisoners had them. And suddenly, everybody says, suddenly. You know, when you sing at home, when the landlord is making his usual trouble and you sing. When your wife is, you know, cooking up some things and making some fire. Not fire in the kitchen, fire in the living room and fire in the bedroom. Way to sing. And when the children are here and there, it appears to say, mommy or daddy, this is not going to happen. We're going to be in charge. We're going to take control. And then you sing, okay. That is the time to sing. When your trials are greatest, when your situations are kind of bleak and black, you don't know what to do, when everything becomes almost unsolvable and ungovernable, that is the time to sing. In the midnight of life, when things are tough and when things are difficult, you pray and you sing. And you see, suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundations of the prison were shaking. And immediately, what happened? All the doors were open. Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. You know, I know some people are saying that, you know, when there's trouble, trouble for the minister, trouble for the preacher, trouble for the apostle, trouble for the missionaries, you know, it will close doors. And they're sending prayer requests home. And they're saying, headquarters church, pray for us. The doors are about to close. Because you know what? We have trouble here. We have persecution here. We have trial here. We have this one here. We have that one here. The doors are going to close. I say, no. Read your Bible again. That when the adversaries come up, and when the adversities multiply, it's when more doors will open. Read Revelation chapter 2, chapter 3. You'll find out that it says, yes, I know what they say, and I know what they do, and I know the kind of pressure, persecution they are bringing upon you, those of the synagogue of Satan. And yet it says, I've set before you an open door which nobody can close. Never you seek again. The persecution will close your door. Your doors will open. Never you seek again. That adversity or trouble. Or you know, this one is making trouble. That one is making trouble. It means my ministry is over. There's trouble everywhere. There's adversity everywhere. There's oppression. My feet are put in stalls. In fact, the laws of the land, they bring restriction upon my life. And now ministry is all over. Lord Jesus, come. Now there's nothing else for me to do. All the doors are closing. No, begin to sing and your songs will open doors. I said your songs will open doors. In fact, you know, I told you that this is the only kind of singing I find in the New Testament. And that is, I find in Acts of the Apostles. That if the singing is right, the singing should open the hearts of the people. Should open the door of faith into the hearts of people. The kind of singing, even the singing we have in church, the kind of singing that closes the door to preaching, and the door to miracle, and the door to joy, and the door to happiness, the kind of singing that closes the door, that you will not find in the Bible. Every time you sing, and you sing in the Spirit of the Lord, with the power of the Lord, doors will open. And I pray your doors will open. I said your doors will open. By the way, you see, here are apostles singing. Not choir. Here is Apostle Paul. And here is Silas, and they were, their feet were in the stalls. Some things were called bad things that happened to them. And then those apostles, they sang, if the church will come back to Bible days. When apostles sing, it's a different thing. When prophets sing, it's a different thing. And when people have anointing, power, authority, when they sing, it's a different thing. And when I sing, your doors will open. You know, some people, they think now, Pastor, you are the GS, the general superintendent, the apostle of the church. You be singing to those who are supposed to sing, and you preach and pray. I say, no, let's go back to the Bible. If we go back to the Bible, the apostles sang, the apostles preached, and the apostles prayed, and their singing will open your door in Jesus' name. Let's come back now. It says, and everyone's bands were used. Deliverance for you today. Dominion for you today. Healing for you today. Ability and courage and power for your hour has come upon your life today in Jesus' name. Prevailing prayer, prevailing power of prayer and praise. Prevailing power of prayer and praise. Prayer is a mighty force, a great force. But not prayer with panic. Not prayer with perplexity, not prayer with fear, not prayer with doubt, not prayer with, I don't know what's going to happen, not prayer with watching the faces of people, not prayer with opening your eyes and closing your eyes and looking at the time. I mean prayer that is released from a free heart. And prayer that comes out is pouring out of the heart. Not prayer with complaint. Not prayer with criticism. Not prayer with thinking this and thinking that. A prayer that just releases you and releases everything within you unto the Lord. That's the kind of prayer we're going to pray today. And you're going to find here in that hall, there's going to be a miracle. And in your hall, there's going to be a miracle. In your hall over there, there's going to be a miracle. When the people of God, when they pray and they sing unto the Lord. That's why Paul the Apostle said, I will pray in the Spirit, I'll pray with understanding. And Paul the Apostle, remember an apostle, he said, I will sing in the Spirit, and I will pray with, I will sing with understanding. And it is that kind that breaks every yoke. Is that kind that brings anointing down. And that anointing will come to me in Jesus' name. But you know, look up here, look up here. I'm just trying to help you. When the apostles sing, and you criticize in your heart, you close your own door that's about to open. When the apostles sing, and then you say, but why is the apostle singing? What does it keep to his preaching and praying? We are the people supposed to do the singing. Well, when you come to do your singing, no door will open. But when you agree, when you understand, when you know that we are following the Bible, that this is Bible church, it's not a kind of, you know, all these new generational church, Bible church. And we do what they did in Bible times. Then we're going to have the result. And we're going to have the miracle and the outbreak, the open door, the arch in Bible times. We're going to have it. I said we're going to have it. I'm dividing the message to 3 points. Number one, the power of prayer and praise before deliverance, not after deliverance. The power of prayer and praise.
That you have been blessed with this powerful message. Our address is at the bottom of the screen. I believe you will join us one of this Sunday to worship together. Thank you. God bless you. Let us pray. Our mighty Father, we glorify your name and thank you, Lord, because of this powerful message. I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, you will touch those people who are in need of salvation, those people who are in need of prosperity, those people who are in need of healing. and the power by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, they will give testimony because of this message. In Jesus' name we pray.
Say it one more time, say, oh, 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 Lord.